man, because if you remember scripture, it says, so as a man thinketh, so is he. So my spirit man does have an ability to think correctly, correctly. And I think that it is important as the body of Christ that we make people aware that when God sent his son, it wasn't just to heal a portion, but it was the whole body. The Apostle Paul said, as your soul does prosper, so does your body and all of these other things. So we want to make sure that we don't cheat ourselves out of what God has made available for his people. And we're talking about whole completeness. God wants the whole body. He wants us healed in every area. But a lot of us, remember, we don't want to talk about things that sometimes seem spooky or seems embarrassing. But in order to get complete healing, we got to confront the issues.
Amen. Well, Carolyn, tell me.
Yes.
I got to ask some questions.
Uh-oh.
Before you go into your spiel.
Okay.
All right. Are you qualified to talk about mental health?
I'm glad that you asked that question.
Okay, talk to the mic. Talk to the audience.
Greetings in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Welcome everyone from outside. Yeah. Prophets too, and my pastor.
Mm-hmm.
When you say qualified, I tell you, not only am I qualified. 30 years for dealing with depression, Prophetess Tanila, okay? Mm-hmm. 30 years of a broken heart. Mm-hmm. When we have our mission, when I say that every week, to heal the brokenhearted and to see that those that were bound by the issues of life would be set free, I did not realize. Now, I went to traditional therapists and people with mental health conditions and things like that. But it was not until I connected with my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and this man on the side of me who took me on an hour each week and pulled me back together again, okay? When you say qualified, when he gives you a heart, see now, Apostle, everybody can't deal with this. Everybody can't deal with the grieving heart. Everybody, they don't have words to say. They're not comforting words like you do, Prophetess Tanila, or like you, Pastor. You know, there are certain people that's just not lined up quickly. Those are not the gifts,
right?
Okay.
Right.
But when you've been brokenhearted like me for 30 years, okay, 30 years, it feels like, can I say, it feels like I'm out of jail. You know, well, my mind was in jail, okay? Caught up. So now I'm not. I'm healed and delivered, set free.
Yes, Lord.
You know, now you said that there was. Now help me understand how one comes out of a depression. Okay. Especially this mental, spiritual depression. What did you do? Did you go shopping? Spend some money? Did you take a vacation? What remedy? You know, what did God do? Was it just words? What was it that removed that depression?
When you get in line, your mind, body, and your soul all together.
Okay.
Like what Pastor always say, I couldn't take medication. You know, there's a certain percentage of people that cannot take medication. Even though there's the Advils, the Tylenols, the Cetirins, there's all types of stuff, but I couldn't. Okay, I couldn't take it, nice long tea. When you say you can go to a counselor.
Okay, okay.
But until you have been delivered and set free, you're still bondage. You can take the medication, but once you stop it and once it's out of your system, your mind is rubbermaid. It goes back to what it was already. So you need the healing of the Lord.
So God just removes the depression out of one's life. Is that what you're saying?
But then again, when you get, now I know scientists and neuroscientists and always say, the mind is the most powerful thing in the universe. Until I came to Tragedy to Triumph Ministries, once again, this person on the side of me, that one thing that he doesn't teach, and you will know that as soon as you get there, no, the power is not in the mind. The tongue.
It's in your mouth.
Power of life and death. When you can line those in, so I had to line up. Right. It was through conditioning, just like those two work out. You got to work out your mind, too. So your mouth, your tongue had to line up with the mouth, and then you have to say, hey, listen, you get your thoughts, you got to seek ye first the kingdom of God.
Okay.
And then all these things will be added to you.
So, Pastor.
Yes, sir.
Are you saying to the audience today that there is a remedy?
Yes, sir.
Of your thought life and your words.
Yes, it is, sir.
Your thoughts and
it
your
is.
Words.
Absolutely.
Can change any your depression or your or what you're dealing with.
Yes, it can. And I'm gonna be very transparent, Apostle. I was diagnosed with chronic post-traumatic stress in 2007. I've been in Desert Storm. I've had three massive heart attacks, and a lot of different things have happened. I survived a drive-by at 16. So I've had a lot of trauma in my life. What helped me is that I wanted to be helped. I would have highs and lows, and I'm not talking about somebody that's not saved, somebody that doesn't know Christ. I'm talking about know Christ, have a relationship with Christ, have a high. Just, I'm happy one minute. Wow, I'm down. I'm real angry. And I could not take the medicine. I had a bad allergic reaction. So for somebody that could not take medication, now I have to come to the real remedy. And the real remedy is according to, that's why we use Philippians 4 and 6. It talks about, and the peace of God.
Yes.
And so I had to understand, first of all, the peace of God to reign in my life. There's something that I have to commit to verbally. Because, and remember, Jesus told the disciples, look, unless you believe, I have to state my confession of faith. James 5, I think it is, say, confess. God, I got to confess. I know you know, but I got to confess. God, I'm messed up. I'm having all of these issues and things. So, God, I'm confessing. First of all, I believe in the power of healing. You have whatsoever you say. Apostle, if I said that wrong, and I would say, well, I guess I can't take mess. I guess I'm just stuck like this. What I did, I released something in the atmosphere that's out there that sets up a system of thinking.
Okay.
We set up our own system of thinking, which either can become a door of release or a door of bondage. It's up to you. And so anyone who's watching tonight, the first thing, you have to admit that you have a problem. And you have to be willing to receive the help. We can't lie about this. We can't blame other people. I'm messed up because of what somebody else said. Yes, they might have did that. But you know what? The last I looked, the Bible said, he who the Son is set free. So if you believe that the Son of God, Jesus Christ, can set you free, you can have newness of life. You can be able to renew your mind. But I need to tell folks something. This is not a one-hit wonder. You got to renew your mind on a daily basis. That's why I said spiritual mental health is something that we have to submit and commit to every day. Well, Pastor, I hear you, but how do I practice spiritual mental health? Well, I need to have a prayer life. I need to have a relationship first with God, and I need to read my word, because there's power in the word of God. It's healing in the word of God. The reason why a lot of people cannot move past tragedies in their life, hurts in their life, is because they're not willing to do what God is requiring. I don't care how anointed I may be or any of my team. We can lay hands on you all day long, but if you're not willing,
there you go.
2 Chronicles 20 and 20. First of all, believe the Lord your God and be established, and then believe my prophet, and so shall you prosper. And so there is a system that God has set up in his word. You have to know that God wants you whole.
Amen. Now, Super Saint, have you ever had to deal with depression?
Yes.
No, not you, Super Saint.
Yeah, it's me, Pastor. Uh-oh.
And how did you deal with it at that time?
It was hard, but prayer, as the pastor said, reading your word, that's what kept me level-headed. I mean, me and my father physically working out, that helped me in the beginning. Like, okay, if I work out, that's going to keep my mind off of it. But I would still come home to this dark place and just feeling empty. But when I read the word, I listened to my worship music, that kept me and being in that constant communion with God. But yeah, it was bad. I felt like it was just me.
Now you said something interesting. You said physical exercise helped you with dealing with depression or what have you. How so? What did this make you feel better at the time, or it just
that what was it? And I mean, helping to keep my mind off of so many things that were going on around me, and it did help me feel better because it just always felt like something was sitting on my chest, like I gotta work out, I'm too young for this. But right. physically, it just made me feel better. I mean, it still does now. I don't deal with that anymore. Right, thank you, Jesus. Right. But, yeah, it helps.
Right. You're Carolyn,
I'm going to be a apostle. Super Saint. First of all, can you tell people how you identified with depression? How did you even know that it was depression? And not just, okay, I'm just sleepy.
Right. For me, it was how I identified with it. It just felt like the sun could be out, but it was just darkness inside of me. And suicidal thoughts would come on, like my life doesn't matter. So depression, it was just overpowering. It felt like a spirit that just took over me that I just couldn't shake.
Wow.
Yeah.
What's so bad about it? It doesn't matter whatever social, economic status you have or a culture you come from. That's what we're all going to experience.
Right.
We will experience, and that's what we're talking about right now. Like the three phases. The first phase, first stage, is grief, and we know grief is a person's process. It's a normal process, actually. Right. It's a normal process.
And it's okay.
And it doesn't matter if you've been, if you lost a loved one, if you lost an income, as Pastor did, he went from $16 an hour to $6 an hour.
Give me that.
Exactly. We lost status. All that will play a part on
it.
It
does. Yeah. Yeah.
Doesn't matter how much money you have.
Right. So you mean, wait a minute, kid. If I had $1 million, boo, I ain't gonna be depressed. It's about the money. I mean, God is cool and everything, and don't get me wrong, but give me $1 million. I'll be happy.
Let me tell you, you know what they always say, more money, more problems, right? That's what they say.
Let me find out.
I hear you.
One of the greatest people. The greatest people in the Bible and greatest people that we can touch have been depressed. Look at our friend that we know on her own network. Oprah says she battles with it. Terry Bradshaw won, 4 Super Bowls? He said right after throwing the touchdown and stuff like that, he would be in the locker room crying. Abraham Lincoln. Our forefounders. Okay.
Right.
Our brother Job that we were talking about. It is it's people on your pews. You know, it just don't affect one person, it affects the family. It does not affect the job. It affects the organization. It doesn't affect the student, it affects the school. It affects the body of Christ. When you're sitting next to somebody every day, but they can wear this mask.
That's true.
And you never know what's going on.
But did y'all hear something Apostle said, which is good? I caught this.
What do you say?
Now, Apostle, this is important. You're absolutely right. Because some people will say, well, if I had a different partner, my life would be better.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
If I had more money, my life would be better. Watch this. It may change a circumstance, but it doesn't change a condition.
Yes, right.
The condition still exists. All you got to do is look at, what was that man, Rockefeller, had all that money, but he had to drink breast milk, okay? So money may be able to pay for something, but I need healing. Healing is supernatural. Exactly. Okay, and that's why I said we're not, we want to make sure that we advocate this. We're not knocking anybody that takes medication. Mm-hmm. God can heal through medication too.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
That's not what we're saying. Mm-hmm. What we're saying though is that we want people to understand that spiritual mental health is part of our Christian wellness as a relationship. Mm-hmm. It mm-hmm. really is. Because how can I really be a true testimony to God's word? And I can't believe that God is able to keep me every day. I can't believe and trust that God will provide for me as he so stated in his word.
Okay.
I can't believe that with all the terrorists and stuff going on, that God will cover me.
Right.
That God will protect me. These are everyday issues that we can't give people a fake facade. Okay, when God bless you with this money, baby, your life will be right. Mm-hmm. Not necessary.
No.
Come on.
I've heard this said before.
Yes.
I think it's a book called Pigs in the Parlor. You ever read that book?
That sounds familiar, but I can't say I've read it.
Well, the author talks about, it's a very popular book, Pigs in the Parlor. It talks about spiritual warfare and how the spirits come on you. And one of the things that causes schizophrenia and depression, and sickness and disease.
Mm-hmm.
And it basically says you have to cast these things out of you or get circumcised. Not circumcised. What's the thing?
I know show. Oh, Lord.
Circumcised.
Yes.
Exercise.
Exercise. Right.
So I hear that. And it sounds like it has some credibility to it.
Right.
But listening to you all, I'm hearing that depression could be as simple as negative thinking.
Ooh. Oh, amen.
Thinking bitterness, anger.
Yes, sir. Yes,
you know, it could be as simple of you got your mind on yourself so much that you not put your mind on helping others.
Amen.
Yes. And like you were saying, Apostle, and the only way that we're going to know that is to identify it. Mm-hmm. That's the first sign. Just to identify it, then everything else will line up.
Amen. Mm-hmm. So can an individual identify it themselves, or do they need to go to someone like Super Saint?
They need to go
or Pastor You to have it help them identify it.
First of all, if they've been numb all that time and been bitter and angry, it's just them. But guess what?
Mm-hmm.
We can guarantee you go to their household.
Mm-hmm.
Their mother was bitter. Their mother's mother was bitter.
Okay.
Exactly, and it's a lifestyle.
Okay.
It's a lifestyle.
But honey, just touch on that little end part he said. Will you know without going and getting help that's what's wrong? Because you experienced that.
Oh, you won't know. Listen, I'm going to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
As we all know, the story of my daughter, okay?
Right.
I didn't realize what, I didn't know what depression was.
Well, right.
We knew something was wrong with my cousin that was sleeping in the bedroom all the time and alcoholism. But we as our culture, we just swept it underneath the rug. The elephant was in the room, but nobody was talking about it. You know, we didn't address it. We didn't go get help or anything like that. You won't know that it's you because you're you. Someone else has to be, and the closest friends around you will have to be able to identify it.
That's true, because you know what, Apostle, that's what I say. I don't mind being transparent.
Right.
People can judge me. I'm just trying to help somebody.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
Now, let me ask you this.
Right.
I have a friend in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And I'm telling you, the spirit on this friend is totally negative.
Mm-hmm.
I can't talk to this friend for more than negative. 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Negative.
I feel the spirit. It's so strong. It's crazy, crazy.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, hey, so-and-so, how you doing? Oh, I'm doing great. Da, da, da. The kids are doing da, 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 da. I said, oh, man, that's wonderful. But I have this, and then I'm down with that, and so-and-so got sick, and my friend, other friend, got hit by a car yesterday, and
I'm like, negative, right.
I gotta go. I hate being rude.
Right.
You know, I don't know if she thinks because I'm Pastor Larry, she can dump all this stuff on me, but I can't handle it.
Have we been there before?
I can't handle it.
Time and time, same story.
You know, that negative thinking. Have you been around folks, Super Saint, that is negative?
Every day at work. Oh, Lord, you gotta keep me. Yeah.
Don't say that to me. They're gonna be watching.
I'm gonna call it out.
What happens to your family when you have a 9 to 5 and you can get away from it? But what happens when it's
gotta go people home
in your
household?
In your home.
What if it's people that's.
I nipped that in the bud.
What if it was your significant other?
That's what I'm talking about.
Wife.
Just me and my bae.
You have to.
Bae, when bae come home,
right?
I know she watching.
Come on.
I say, bae,
mm-hmm.
how did your day go?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
He used to always be negative stuff.
Right.
I say, bae.
No. Yeah.
I said, God got a promotion for you.
Mm-hmm.
And he's going to give you something bigger and better than that. Right now, you're just going through a boot camp.
Amen.
Man, she finally figured that thing out.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That she's going through something. It's not, don't stay in that place.
No.
You know, don't stay in that place. And I tell you how awesome God is. God promoted her.
I know.
So God gave her a promotion. Right. And now she comes and says, you know, people talk to me differently now. Because you're the dang boss.
That's right. They got to talk different.
You know, they talk to me differently.
They got
to
talk differently.
And they know. And I said, now you just got to have a posture with a position.
Ooh, right.
Okay.
You know.
There you go.
Because, you know, you've been down for so long. I got to promote you.
Mm-hmm.
Now you got to walk upright in the posture.
Come on.
I run this. Mm-hmm. And God runs it through you.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? And you walk in that glory.
Yes.
Because who gave you the promotion?
Mm-hmm. The Bible said promotions come from God.
Come on. Mm-hmm.
Not to north, east, south, or west.
That's right.
But
so at your job, okay, your J-O-B, your job, experience, don't, that's not where you're going to be permanently.
No. Amen.
Amen.
You know,
amen.
You're going to come up out of that, and God's going to promote you
amen.
To where you're supposed to be in that place or in another place.
Amen.
Because you're his daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
You know.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
There's something too that I had to go through. It's called the process too.
The process. Come on.
The process when I worked for this particular company.
Mm-hmm.
It was the actual platform to develop me for a lot of what I'm doing now.
Mm-hmm.
So one thing that you said, you have to have your forward glasses on when you feel like you're going backwards.
Yes.
Yes. You have to remember to always shift every day.
Come on.
You got to shift every day. Because if you don't, we have a tendency to measure what we're going through as being necessarily what we're going to become. No, what you're going through, if you process it correctly and think correctly, it is necessary tools to develop you, to chisel you, to carve you into the man or woman of God that God's bringing you into. We think suffering is a curse word.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
No. Mm-hmm. No, it is a word that through keeping a dedicated commitment to God, it keeps me consecrated.
Amen.
The more you pick on me, the more you say things to me, it challenges me to stay committed to what God said, operate in my humility. You have to, the one thing I love of what you said, nobody can bind a strong man's house unless you first bind that strong man. Now, let's broaden that out.
Mm-hmm.
This is the house that God lives in. It's up to me if I allow the enemy to come in here with depression and all these things to command my house.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
That's right. Come on, Doc.
Things will come to the door.
Come on.
But it's up to us to welcome them in.
Come on.
See, that's why, and I'm going to talk
about.
That's
good. That's good.
Okay.
Yeah. Keep on. That's good.
Okay. I'm going to talk about me.
Mm-hmm.
When I was first dealing with the post-traumatic stress, I would say, man, if they would just leave me alone, I wouldn't go off like that. No. I don't care what somebody else is doing. Only I can pull the trigger.
Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Only I can pull the trigger.
Mm-hmm.
You may give me the bullet.
Come on,
but it's up to me to pull the trigger.
Right.
So what brought my healing was being responsible for me. Mm-hmm.
Right.
And Pastor as well, too.
That's good.
When we were talking about...
right.
That's good.
Can someone identify themselves?
Right.
Mm-hmm. You said you had to have that heart where... See, I know the story.
Right,
she that knows. Your, yeah. your family had to come to you and say,
right.
You're... You know, like the commercial, you're right. not... You.
No, you're not you. Something wrong.
The oh, that's commercial.
Yeah, yeah. You're not you. And you had to be the person to accept it, to identify it, right?
Yeah, because we don't want to feel like we're crazy. Mm-hmm. I ain't me. I'm good. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You ain't good.
But just right. as it, just as we yeah. know, you have sugar diabetes, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's a condition of the mm-hmm. pancreas, right? Your mind, right. your mind mm-hmm. gets sick.
Mm-hmm.
Your mind gets sick as well, too. Mm-hmm. And like you were saying, we're not knocking medication or anything like that.
Right.
But you have to line everything up.
Right. Right.
Well, you know, mm-hmm. I like what okay. you said about
mm-hmm.
it's at the door.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
One. You know, God told Cain,
uh-oh,
sin lieth at the door.
Come on, Pastor, talk to us.
Don't let that sucker in.
Yeah.
But he did.
Mm-hmm.
He did.
And he got the negative thoughts. Everything. He got thoughts of murder. Mm-hmm. He got thoughts of just disobedience. Mm-hmm. And mm-hmm. he let it in and he acted on it.
He acted on it.
He mm-hmm. acted on what was laying at his door.
Mm-hmm.
You know, every day sin lieth mm-hmm. at the door.
Come on, Pastor. Mm-hmm. Come on, talk to us.
You know,
mm-hmm.
we have to make sure mm-hmm. that it lieth dead.
Yes.
It lies there. We're on a whole nother plane and a whole nother mm-hmm. level of mm-hmm. life and thinking. We just don't posture ourselves and position ourselves
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
for God. You have to come to a point, and I'm just preaching mm-hmm. this to myself
go
right
ahead,
now, that you are God.
Mm-hmm.
You can do all things through Christ which strengthens you.
Mm-hmm.
You are Christ.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You can do all things. I mean, wait a minute.
Come on.
The Bible says you can do mm-hmm. all things. Mm-hmm. Now, the Bible don't lie.
No, it don't.
Right.
I only know one other dude
mm-hmm.
that can do all things.
I don't know either. Right, but one.
And that's my brother Jesus.
Yes.
Come on.
Wait a minute, Jesus.
You said something.
You, I know, can do all things. And then he had the nerve to tell me, let this mind
uh-oh.
Be in you,
mm-hmm.
which is also in Christ Jesus. Mm-hmm. All right, so I can think like him.
Mm-hmm.
I can talk like him, because if I'm thinking whatever in my mind,
mm-hmm.
going to come out my mouth.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So you mean I can be just like mm-hmm. Jesus?
Right. Come on now.
That's the best positive thinking
mm-hmm. yes.
you can have. You think yes. like that all day. And don't right. care what people think.
No.
Jesus didn't care what people thought because he was
he
Jesus.
He sure didn't, mm-hmm. did he? He didn't.
He said, you see me, you see the Father.
I like that.
I'm like,
confident.
Like confident.
Confident.
You know, the reason you don't love me, you don't love the Father.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? You don't love God. You love God. You love me.
You love me. You don't love God.
You know you don't love God. I can tell you. How you know I don't love God? Because you don't love me.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You know, so I can look at you and say, you ain't no Christian. What? I dare you. You ain't Christ-like.
Where the fruit at?
Where the fruit?
They know my disciples.
By their fruit.
Mm.
See, it is important mm-hmm. to have, and you really, this is a good show.
Because I knew, I told you, we got to do this.
It's a good show because mm-hmm. positive thinking,
right.
some people think positive thinking mm-hmm. is thinking positive about themselves.
No, sir.
Positive thinking mm-hmm. is to know that you are Christ.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's good. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
And now when you open that Bible, and when you start reading and seeing mm-hmm. what Christ did,
right.
and then he had that nerve to say, mm-hmm. you're going to do greater things than these.
Wow.
What?
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to do greater things than what Jesus did?
Mm-hmm.
Greater things,
that's
he
right.
says. Yeah, greater works, he yeah. says.
Absolutely.
Did he say that?
That's what he said. Mm-hmm. He did.
He said, you can do greater works.
Mm-hmm.
And, yes, well, and he told the disciples,
mm-hmm.
He told me.
I'm a disciple.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
He called mm-hmm. the foolish things to confound the mighty.
Absolutely.
Well, I know I was a foolish person.
Oh, me too.
Absolutely. We all are.
Now, Apostle, I love how you do this. Let's play devil advocate. Because it's somebody watching, ain't even trying to hear all this. Okay? And can I just throw one punch right quick?
Hit him.
Okay, well, you know what? You don't know what I've been through. Okay? Now, there's something called default thinking. Default thinking means that is a thinking that I continue to reflect back to, no matter how much information you try to download, no matter how great of opportunity you try to show me that God is, I have a tendency to fall back into what I'm used to. Right. And now watch this.
Come on.
Who are you all to tell me that the way I think is wrong?
Come on.
Okay. Now, my loving answer to that is what God has told us is a proven has a proven success record.
Yes.
It's proven.
Right.
And that's the thing, because if what you did worked, then we wouldn't be having this discussion.
Mm-hmm. Right.
We would have to discussion.
Well, you're right. Well, see, you know what I call that?
Yes.
That you were saying?
Uh-huh.
I call that cruise control.
Okay.
Yeah, it does.
Cruise control. Y'all are familiar with cruise control.
Exactly.
Right.
Going down the freeway, you set that cruise control for 70.
Right.
But all of a sudden, there's an old slow vehicle in the front of you, and you got to punch it.
Yes.
And you punch it up to 80, maybe 85.
Whatever.
To get around that slow moving vehicle.
Absolutely.
But what happens when you take your foot off the gas? It goes right back down to 70.
Right.
See, we have to subconsciously change our thinking.
Right.
Because I've seen it done in my life and in many lives. So, prime example, money. You got a cruise control setting for money.
Right.
Give Karen $10,000, ain't a problem, she can handle it.
She good.
Give Karen $50,000, she don't know what to do.
Because it went out.
She don't, it went out of her level.
I got you.
It's beyond her level. So now she's spending it, she's spending it all up.
Okay.
Bam, back down to $10,000, she cool. Mm-hmm. Can handle it. Mm-hmm. You have a person have a church, a pastor have a church, man, he can handle 25 minutes. Mm-hmm. 25 members, he beautiful.
He good.
All of a sudden, the surge come in there, 100 members, he don't know what to do.
Wow.
He'll scare 75 away.
Gotcha.
Until he back to 25.
Gotcha.
Super Saint, as fine as you is.
Woo!
as fine as you is. She out-sings Beyonce.
Oh, that's right.
I'll sing Beyonce. But the minute they invite her to the music awards and have her come to the, you know, the Grammys.
That's
right.
Outside.
See, but that's your subconsciousness.
Exactly.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
You have to see where your cruise control is set and set it for a higher standard.
That's true.
And that is done in your subconscious.
Yes.
And it's done by what you say out your mouth, what you speak, what you read, and you keep saying the positive thing. I do better than that. I can do better. Don't get set, you know, with 25 members.
No way.
I can handle 1,000.
That's right.
10,000. I can do it. And I can see, like, the way you do things now with all these different legacy threes and this. I'm telling you.
Well, I know you just said that.
Your standard is already up there.
It's already up there. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What you're doing is more than where you're at.
Exactly.
Oh, absolutely.
But not really, because where you're at here.
Yeah, exactly. I'm here.
Mm-hmm.
This is where God's going to raise up your church.
Up. Yeah, bring that up.
Yes, you know, now, if you wanted to be a little bootleg preacher and you just wanted to come in on Sundays and preach and that was it, you know, and get the tithes and offerings and go back home and count the money.
Yep, that's it.
That'd have been your level.
Right, that'd have been my level.
That'd have been your level. But no, you're putting it together. curriculums and classes and schools and COOs and CEOs and all that kind of stuff. That's big time thinking. You're not going to stay small. You can't stay small. It's impossible. I'm looking at how professional this is, man.
Yeah, we agree. Yeah, no, everything is professional. Absolutely.
This is very nice.
Absolutely.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So that's where you're going.
Yes, sir.
And that's how come you don't have to be negative.
No. No.
Because you're applying where you want to go.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And he's just not keeping it to himself.
No. Right. No, we invite
him. He's invited for $25. A participant.
$25.
That's a cheap pair of shoes.
Sell it.
That's $4 an hour, right?
Mm-hmm. Can't even get a good pair.
Just exactly.
Well,
$25.
Go ahead. She said cheap pair.
She didn't say cheap.
Okay, inexpensive. Anyway, he's bringing it to the body of Christ because, like you say, it's what you were talking about. This cruise control. It is the atmosphere, the environment that people in. Listen, you can go to a household. My grandson, they diagnosed him as being depressed.
He's six.
What is it? What's a six-year-old?
It's a baby.
Way back in the day, we'd be like, oh, just go on the altar. Or just like, yeah, no, we have to be spiritual. We have to be wise, divine wisdom, and saying, wait, something is not right.
Right.
We can't just put him before, you know, guess what? We have to align things up for him.
Right. And like you guys said at the beginning of the show, and I asked this question, I said, you mean, Pastor, there's mental and spiritual?
Yes, sir.
It is mental and spiritual.
It is.
You have to line up with your...
You got to know when it's a familiar spirit is trying to attack your kids.
Come on.
You know? Then you also got to know the practical things of it as well.
Yes, sir.
You know, you have to be discerning.
Because they're not
going to use that word.
Apostle, they're not going to tell you, a six-year-old is not going to say, my mindset ain't right. I'm feeling a little, they're not going to say, they don't have the verbiage to say, I'm depressed.
Right.
My daughter, who's locked in a mental facility, came back and told me after she had got all lined up with all of her programs.
Right.
You've been depressed all my life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I was like, what? Someone else has to be able to identify, just like family members had to tell
you. She told you was depressed?
She told me, yeah. I just knew the feeling, the sadness inside. Mm-hmm. I didn't know. I was wearing a mask, remember? Right. I didn't know what this sadness was. Why am I sad when I just won manager of the year? Why am I sad? I'm driving a Beamer. And
can you be depressed? Is this a sign of depression, too, if you are... have a self-destructive
behavior. Exactly.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You know, is that depression also? Mm-hmm.
Yes, it is.
It's like you almost destroy your own success.
Mm-hmm. There you go. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's good. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Because you're numb inside. You're numb inside. A rational person wouldn't just go risky behavior or anything like that. It goes on. It's deeper, but absolutely.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But you hit something to monitor your environment, both inner and outer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Monitor both environments, both inner and outer.
Okay.
Because whatever you feed your mind and your spirit, it has a tendency to shape your thinking.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. And because... you had said something earlier about, I think it's Paul says in Romans 12, 1 and 2, I beseech you therefore, brothers, by the mercies of God that you present yourself. So I must always present myself according to the model that Christ is. Because you have to remember this, whatever we have a tendency to look at the longest, we model after.
Mm-hmm.
We model after it. If I watch, and I'm not, why should I say this? I don't want to get in no trouble. If I watch all these crazy reality shows, don't you know that affects my thinking? It does. But if I feed my mind on something, according to Paul, Philippians 4 and 8, think on things that's going to help build.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Watch this. Not just build, but sustain. Sustain. Amen. Come on, Apostle.
Not only build, but sustain.
Sustain.
You know, and that's one thing, too. You know, reading.
Oh yeah, oh, that's yes. good.
Mm-hmm. Is so important. Mm-hmm. But I think it's a spirit, Super Saint.
Uh oh.
When you be trying to read your Bible,
it is our
yeah, you get drowned.
Right. Right. And side breaks.
Come on now. How do you defeat that thing?
Mm-hmm. Don't have a problem.
Oh, you get that problem. You ain't defined that
No, last night I know I was praying and I felt like I had that feeling like, wait a minute, is this just sleepiness or is this something trying to take me out of my. But I'm like, no, God, I got to get up. I got to do walk around, whatever. I got to still talk to you. Like,
right, right.
Wait a minute, you got to talk to me. I got something to say.
Right.
So I get it, though. I get what you're saying. But it's
the coffee revelation.
Change the location or something.
Because you know, I think, and I'm gonna be transparent.
Go ahead.
That I think I sometimes sabotage. Not yes. sometimes,
I know.
Sabotage things.
Mm-hmm.
I have a formula.
Yeah.
For success.
Come on.
Written down. Matter of fact, it might even be in here.
Okay.
I have a formula for success written down here, man. I wrote mm-hmm. this formula down 100 years ago.
Come on, man.
I don't even know if it's even in here.
Wow.
And what I did. Was I would read this mm-hmm. every single day.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha.
Okay. Mm-hmm. It was like my reaffirmation.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Get out of doing it. Just mm-hmm. get out of doing it. It's mm-hmm. 4 pages. Now how can you be lazy
right.
and not read four pages?
Yeah.
I even got a millionaire creed.
I see.
We can if we ain't careful.
You know what
we
I'm saying?
Can.
And I'm like, okay. And when I go back, you know, I'm just journal. I have to keep a journal. I write down things that I desire and stuff. Mm-hmm. But I'll get lazy
mm-hmm.
and won't read.
I'm with you. I understand.
Just won't read. Mm-hmm. I'd rather watch Facebook.
Right. Yeah, we do.
What's your favorite program?
Mm-hmm. Favorite program? I have Amazon, so I just watch.
Okay.
Okay.
All kinds of stuff.
All kinds of cowboys.
It's terrible. Yeah. It's terrible, and I'm admitting it because I want to share my faults
mm-hmm.
so that I can get delivered from that thing because I'm hearing God say, James, I got something for you.
Yeah, he does.
But you just keep going mm-hmm. back to Facebook and Amazon. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
And I need to work. I will stop that.
Mm-hmm.
I will stop it because
mm-hmm.
it's limiting.
Mm-hmm.
what God has for me to do.
Amen.
Because when I get into the Word and I read my affirmations and mm-hmm. things, oh man, it's awesome.
That's it. You just said it. We got to stay
awesome.
In that Word. Reaffirm myself daily.
Yes.
In the Word. That's true. Because you know what? And I'm glad. And if we can, let's hit this too. Busyness does not cure depression.
Mm-hmm.
What it does, it camouflages it.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Now the reason why I said that, Apostle, because, you know, people see that we do a lot in this ministry. It's not for us to camouflage what's going on.
Right.
It is for us to show people that as you allow God
mm-hmm.
to have ownership of your life,
mm-hmm.
he shows you treasure
right.
that's been buried under the ashes for years of your life. Apostle, all of these ideas came out of my hurt and my pain. Tragedy of Triumph Ministry. That's right. Who thinks like that?
Right.
I mean, just in the normal. No.
Right.
Her, the Tragedy of Triumph Ministry, before she even knew that that's what the name was, and she saw it, my vision and mission statement is the same as what she had
Amen.
For this organization that she was going to do.
Amen.
I didn't tell her that. And so I think out of your trouble, you must believe in triumph. You must never lose your confidence of hope.
Mm-hmm.
I tell people this all the time. If your hope is money, that will be short lived.
Mm-hmm.
If your hope is you know having I need a different woman in my life. You cutting yourself short.
Mm-hmm.
There's only one hope that won't fail you.
Come on,
and that's the hope in Jesus Christ. I think it's Hebrews 12 says, "Cast not therefore away your confidence, which has great recompense
of reward."
And we have to stay with that. We have to stay with that. That's why I'm so passionate. Not me, my whole team
mm-hmm.
is passionate about doing this ministry because we know We are truly the poster children for what we're advocating right now. I'm not telling you something, Minister Carolyn, Prophet Sunil, and the others that's going to be involved in this, Pastor Matt, are not telling you something that we read about. Mm-hmm. We tell you something we done lived through. And I'm not afraid to tell the whole entire world, whoever's watching tonight, that God is not the author of confusion. So if there's confusion in my mind, that's not of God. And I need a new author. I need a new author. You need to cancel who's writing on the pages of your mind and get an author that writes life and not death. And then how we interpret what has been written on our mind through the Word of God, now we must commit to speaking what we believe.
Amen. 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 Speak what you believe.
Speak what you believe.
You know, I tell my wife all the time, babe, I'm this closer to getting, I tell people, and she hears me,
that plane.
I'm closer to getting this jet.
I know you are.
But I know I am.
I know you are.
I know it.
I'm going to ride with you.
And she said, why do you always tell people you're closer to getting a jet? Because I am. Because I am one.
I can see myself on
it. I can see myself on it, too. With my Stacey Adams suit. And, man, I saw Donald Trump's jet the other day.
Okay, yeah.
That
okay.
Joker is beautiful.
My thinking is small. I'm thinking about one of these jets out here. You know, that's seat right, 10 exactly.
And
20.
And those are nice, like, but
his seats are 500 or something.
And it's huge.
Yeah.
More room on it.
Yeah. I'm not really wanting that something that big.
No, I hear you.
But yeah.
Unless you got an assignment for it.
Unless there's an assignment for it. But you guys have helped me today.
Oh, God bless you, Apostle.
Y'all have helped me today.
Come on, somebody.
And recognize some things that was going on in my head.
Thank you, Jesus.
That I needed to repent of and get back focused.
God bless
on positive. Mm-hmm. And the greatest thing is that God is he's in us.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
He's one with us.
Yes.
We're one with him. Mm-hmm. We are Christ.
Come on now.
You know? We're one. He says we gotta be one.
Gotta be
one. We're not separate from him.
Yes, sir.
So what he can do, we can do.
Absolutely.
What he speak, we can speak.
Yeah,
what he spoke, we can have. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Isn't that right?
Yes, that's right. That's what mm-hmm. the word says.
No, with that, you cannot get depressed.
No. No, you can't. Because there's no platform for it.
Yeah, there's no room, right?
There's no room for it.
That's what I was trying to say. There's no room for it.
Right.
And that's the message that we want to get out. So, watch this. We're not just saying this. We're committing ourselves to it.
Yes.
Now, watch this. Somebody may say this. You know, I don't know why I have to pay for it. It ain't about the money. What it is about you taking ownership
right.
of your life.
Mm-hmm. Bro, this is
right. It ain't
this
about
is, man, this is very. This,
come on now.
If a person is dealing with this issue, it's worth $25.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. We're not trying to get rid of
it. Counselors charge a whole lot more than $25 an hour.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Half hour.
And I can tell you one that charges $140 an hour.
Come on.
And he don't play. He good.
Yeah.
He's good. Christian counselor.
Good. Yeah, mm-hmm. Good.
Good. So anytime. Go ahead. You want to say something? So anytime I find somebody that's complaining about investing in themselves, people of God, those who may watch you, who may not know God, you can come to God in many different ways.
Amen.
Different platforms, but we still stick with the truth, which is the Word of God. Some people may not come to God through just coming to a church service. It may be programs just like this mm-hmm, mm-hmm. that'll help you wake up mm-hmm, mm-hmm. and come out of your stupor. As Jesus dealt with the man that lay by the pool for 38 years, it's time for those who's been laying by the bed of excuses. Yes, you may have a legitimate issue. Mm-hmm. We get it. Mm-hmm. You were done wrong. We get it. But we want to show you and introduce you to one who's always right. Who will make it right in your life. And that's why we're not just sharing this to impress folk. This is how we believe. This is how we live. We're also benefactors mm-hmm. of programs just like this.
Mm-hmm. This is how we got healed.
Right. Absolutely.
This is how we got healed.
You know, I think it's going to be a great time in the Lord. We're looking. And this is going to be on. This is going to be ongoing. That's what I want people to know. We are committed to this. A lot of times, people say, well, what happens when you have these programs? You get us to where we're going and you drop us. Mm-hmm. No. We are committed to following up with you. Our address is 15105 Broadway, Tragedy to Triumph Ministry. Service time Sunday, 11:30 a.m. Thursday, Hour of Empowerment, 7 o'clock p.m. Church office number, 216-816-6329.
Well, man, tell me, what's happening over at Tragedy to Triumph on New Year's Eve, prophetic? Amen. Who is these beautiful people? What's going on, man? Tell me.
Amen. Well, Apostle, the Lord put in my spirit in November that he wanted me to have a prophetic deliverance and healing service.
Yes.
And so now what makes this so powerful is I had chose someone else. And the plans fell through. And I said, Lord, what am I going to do? Mm-hmm. This awesome woman of God, I met her several months ago. She called me and she said, the Lord told me to ask you, what is it that you need? And I said, well, what I need, I need someone to come and do this prophetic healing and deliver. She said, I'll be there.
Mm.
Now, when you trust God, God always has what he wants. He always, and I don't always say a ram in the bush either. I believe this is what God had designed for us at this time in our life.
Yes.
And she's willing to come. The woman is an awesome woman of God. Mm-hmm. And she told me some things that was on point. Yes. And she really didn't even know me. That was the first time that we had met.
Okay.
And so we're looking for a great time of deliverance, healing. We don't want to go into 2016 dealing with some of these issues or some of these strongholds.
Amen.
He who the Son is set free. There's no expiration date on deliverance. Amen. You can get it right now if you can believe. You can get it on this show right now if you believe.
That's right. That's right.
Amen.
Why don't you go ahead and lead someone to Christ, Pastor?
Okay. We truly thank God for every platform, every opportunity to share the good news of Jesus Christ. And that's what we want to tell you tonight. There's something called good news, which is the gospel of Jesus Christ. And to those who may have been watching us this evening, we want you to know that God is committed to encouraging, to building up the lives of his people. And God has been giving an invitation for those who come to the wedding feast. And what the wedding feast is just a table where God is inviting us to now die to ourselves and receive him as our personal Savior. The Bible said many are called, but few are chosen. And the reason why many are called and few are chosen, because the many didn't answer the call. Mm. So on tonight, I come to tell you, according to the word of God, not according to my theology, my philosophy, but according to God's precious word, is that your life can be changed. You can become whole. So if you don't know Christ as your personal Savior, there's nothing dramatic, there's nothing spooky about it. The Bible said, whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And then once you confess out of your mouth, you need to say, God, forgive me for my sins. And now, Lord, I receive you as my personal Savior. And then immediately find you a Bible-based teaching church so you can become discipled and learn the word of God and get somewhere where you can become a servant. We pray tonight that you will bless. Thank you. We love you with the love of God. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, once again, we have been viewing and listening to Tragedy to Triumph with my main Dr. Noble Donald, Super Saint, and Carolyn.
Yes,
and we're looking forward to not only December 31st, but also the up and coming classes.
Yes, sir.
On well, actually, it's not going to be. It's a
training center. January 6th and January 20th.
Right. But be sure you come out. Right. Or December 31st.
Yes, sir. Doors open at 8:30 p.m. Service starts at 9 sharp.
Amen. God bless you.
God bless you. God bless you, Apostle. I told y'all we needed to do this. It was phenomenal.
Brilliant show.
Yeah. Okay, Apostle, when we know when we come to you, we can't be playing half that because we know you're ready for us.
Well, I got some questions.
And that's the thing that I think has helped y'all too. They don't know what you're going to have.
Oh, you're not going to be listening.
So she's studying up. She's studying up. And she's like, let me prepare now. So, I don't think you intimidate them as much as you used to. They ready for you now.
I'm like, this guy is really on the radio talking that way?
No, just kidding. Hey, we do what we got to do.